Hai mọi người, sau khi chia tay con trai của mình ở trường đại học Oregon ở thành phố Cold Palace thì mình trong xã mình đang tiến về chỗ này là cái Portland, thành phố Portland đó. Mình sẽ đi ngang qua thành phố Portland và mình sẽ tiến về Seattle, thành phố Seattle, tiểu bang Washington.
This made it much more convincing, not only for the investors, but for everyone else. She was interviewed extensively many times by different people in the media, and initially nobody really suspected anything. They didn't think that something criminal was happening, what was going to happen in the future. She was becoming a famous hero in the world of technology startups, somebody who was going to revolutionize medical. So what about the event where she is in real life? All we really have to go on is information we see. Person she appears to be, again, would be different than the person she is. As far as any pathology, any psychopathology like mental disorder, I don't see any evidence that her behavior aligns with any mental disorder. There are certain personality
well, that
disorders
a that seem to be no, we haven't crossed over. We're not
it's
Washington.
What makes the people suspect her there. I've heard many say that she's sociopathic. I don't agree with this, but I'll talk about
this. This is the one comment.
Many say she is narcissistic. Better case can be made for narcissism, but it's still not worth it. I want to talk about this. So looking at the sociopathy, the construct of psychopathy can be divided into two factors. Factor one, or primary psychopathy, factor two, or secondary psychopathy. Sociopathy is really just another name.
This is the Willamette River.
Secondary psychopathy. Now with factor one psychopathy, we see someone who is a pathological liar. They demonstrate fearless dominance, they have force,
right?
Have a low level
yeah,
of
tram.
That's what
it's like a tram.
Personality traits.
Like above ground.
Tend to be manipulative, and they're callous and unemotional. With factor two psychopathy, or sociopathy, you see someone who is irresponsible, impulsive, neurotic, emotionally reactive. Traits. They would have had to have been present in their childhood, and there's no evidence that that's the case. Now with factor one, you run into that same problem. Unclear if these behaviors were manifested in her childhood. As the founder of Theranos, she did seem to be fearless. This is not unusual for a business leader. I would say maybe, probably more common. One can make the argument for the presence here of the dark triad, conceptualized as some clinical characteristics of narcissism, psychopathy, or Machiavellianism. Even the characteristics don't rise to the level of a mental disorder, they don't necessitate. Triad traits are actually very common among business leaders. The dark triad is not considered to be adaptive from a social point of view, but the traits can be adaptive in terms of business success. And I've also heard people comment about her intense stare. Does that point anything? I think it's probably just a product of her intensity and focus. I don't see any evidence that indicates anything else. I've also heard people comment about her voice being deep, right? This is popular on the internet. See some videos out there. Some have reported that her voice is naturally higher. Now others have said her voice appeared in Indian coverage. On those videos, it's actually a lower voice. So it's hard to know what's going on there, but if I had to guess, I would say that it's her actual voice. It would be hard to maintain that deep voice.
Self-organized army, 700,000 during World War II.
Yeah, and maybe this is all these different things. Results of the